My name is Ashish Agarwal, and I'll be delivering this lecture to you. So before commencing the session, just a quick round of update regarding my YouTube channel, which is youtube.com/AshishAgarwal_GG. So if you haven't visited the channel, I would request you to do visit the channel and do like, share and subscribe the channel. The channel is dedicated to Golden Gate related. Thank you. In this section, we are going to discuss about how to add a new table in existing Golden Gate configuration. So suppose customer is running your GoldenGate environment for last 1 year and no issues. But suddenly a new requirement pops up where customer wants to add one or more than one column into the existing GoldenGate configuration. So how do you do that? So the first requirement is to add a new table into the GoldenGate configuration. What you require to do is, the first step is you need to add the tran data into the GoldenGate source side. So by adding the tran data means enabling the supplemental logging at table level, which we have already discussed in one of the videos. So add tran data. You can do at GGSA level, you can execute add tran data, and on the source side, you can add the supplemental log. Once you have done that, so add tran data basically will enable the supplemental logging at table level. Once you have done that, stop the source extract. Once the extract process is stopped, add the new table details in extract parameter file and data pump parameter. After that, stop the replicate on target and make the changes with new table in replicate parameter. So basically use the map statement on. Once you have done this, start extract and data pump on source side. Once extract and data pump processes are started on source side, perform initial load of new table. So perform the load of data from source table to the target. Once you have done that, once it is completed, then start the replicate. So in our environment, we are already, the practical which we are going to discuss today, we already have data replication happening from DEPT11 to DEPT22 table. Right. Now, what we want to do is, we have a new table on target side. So what we want, that DEPT11 data should be replicated to DEPT_copy22 table. We want. Okay. So first of all, let us discuss about how to add a new table into our existing GoldenGate configuration. So for that purpose, what I'll do is, we'll use this table DEPT. Okay. So first step is connect to the database. So this is our existing GoldenGate configuration where GoldenGate is currently running for. Okay. So the first step is adding the tran data on the table. So what we need to do is, we want to add the replication from DEPT11 to DEPT_copy22. Okay. So what we need to do is, we need to do DB login first of all, so that database connectivity is established. So you can do info credential store. You can do info credential store. So do DB login, user ID alias, source GG1 underscore PDB1 for adding that one. Once tran data, once DB login is done, now do add tran data. So remember, if you are using multi-tenant architecture that is pluggable, container pluggable, then in that case, to add that tran data, you need to log into pluggable database. Okay. Now do add tran data, PDB1, which is pluggable database name, dot schema name, dot table name, which is DEPT. So tran data will be added. Now tran data is very important for you to add. If tran, it is one of the mandatory thing. If your tran data is not enabled, you will not be able to replicate your updates and deletes. GoldenGate will complain. Okay. What is tran data? Follow the video on available on supplemental logging. Okay. Now Trandata basically adds extra column into redo log so that a row can be uniquely identified. So if it's not present, then your insert will work fine, but updates and deletes, GoldenGate will not be able to uniquely identify on target. Hence, the replication will not. Now, in our case, because DEPT11 to DEPT22 replication is already happening, so you will get the mess. So we already enabled DEPT11 supplemental logging. So you are getting this message. It is already enabled. Suppose it is not enabled and you are enabling it for the first time, you will get that, you will get the message logging of supplemental redo data is enabled or successfully enabled for table pdb1.ggtraining1.dpt. Once you have enabled the supplemental logging, that is stranded, stop the extract process existing. So which is stop ext int09 and stop data pump as well. Remember, GoldenGate also accepts wildcard as well. So if you want to stop all the processes in your environment, you can give stop star. So it will stop all the processes which are part of your GoldenGate GGS table. Okay. And if you want to say, for example, stop all the processes which starts with D, you can just give start D star. In our case, they are already stopped. So it is giving you the message that it is already stopped. If it is not, then it will give, it will stop it. Okay. So now these are stopped. Once these are stopped, then what you need to do, you need to add this table, new table, edit param ext int 09, edit the extract parameter file, add the new table in your environment. So we'll do table pdb1.ggtraining1.dpt1. So in our case, we are doing multiple filtration, etc. So you might find, so these all, so how to put comment in a GoldenGate parameter file is just put double hyphen. So these are commented. That means they are not used. So we are using this pdb1.ggtraining1.dpt. Once you have done it, save it and close it. Okay. Same way, edit param dpint09. Here as well, you need to include the new table. So in our case, this table is already part of it, but if it's completely new table on source as well, you can just give table pdb1.ggtraining1.dpt1. But in our case, this is already there, so we don't need it. Once you have done, save it and close it. Verify the changes, view param extint09. Yeah, view param. So I see this new table, which we have added, view param DPINT09. Yeah, DPT11 is still there. So it's fine. Once you are done, now go to target side. This is GGate2, which is target. On target side, stop the replicate. Stop REPINT09. Edit param REPINT09. Add the new table for your configuration. Map pdb1.ggtraining1.dpt11, comma target pdb2.ggtraining2.dpt_copy2. So as I mentioned, we have a requirement from the customer where we want to add the new GoldenGate table into our replication. So DPT11 to DPT_copy22, which is already created in the table. We want to add it. Okay. So DPT11 to DPT_copy22, we are adding. Okay. So if you look at our existing parameter effect, that is complete possibility. Source table DPT11 is getting replicated to two target tables, DPT22 as well as DPT_copy22. So the same source table is getting replicated to two target tables, DPT11 as well as DPT_copy22. Okay. So once you are done, save it and close it. Now, go to source side. Here you now need to start your extract and data pump. Don't start replicate right now. Just start data pump. Okay. So now once your extract and data pump are started, okay, after that, what you need to do is you need to perform the initial load from source to target. Okay. So initial load, you can use either export import or via DB link or Golden Gate initial load you can use. Okay. So we are going to use in one of our previous videos, we discussed about how to perform initial load in Oracle GoldenGate. So we created some processes. So we are going to use the same process, edit param load one. We'll use direct load. So we just want to perform the initial load of DEPT11 to DEPT underscore copy 22 on target. So edit param load 2. So here, what we'll do is we'll map pdb1.ggtraining1.dep, so dept underscore copy 2. Copy appended by semicolon. Okay. So once you are done, save it and close it. Now you can go ahead and start load one here. You can go ahead and start load one process. So if you do info load one, so GoldenGate has capability of performing the initial load, which is very important point. You can just like if there is small data and if the structure of tables is present on source and target, this is quick and easy way. So it is running. Right now it is processing first record. So if you go to target side, if your load 2 is running, info load 2, it is starting right now. It is not running. You can check the view report load 2. So it is running. So automatically this is direct load. Once it completes, it will be stopped. So once it is stopped, you can verify the data in the table on target. So you can see select star from dept underscore copy 22. Describe, we have more columns on target. So I'll do call dname one for a ten, call location one for a ten, call country for a 20, and call city format a 15. Set lines 200. Okay, so now you see the initial load has successfully happened. Even though other column, because these are the extra columns, these are some of the extra columns which you see here. So that's why you don't see the value in those columns, but the initial load has successfully happened. Okay. Now, once initial load is completed successfully. So another reason is there are extra columns and we haven't provided the column mapping yet. So GoldenGate by default maps only those columns which have same names between sources. Now here we don't have same names between source and target, and on source you have only three columns. Like I'll show you on source, if you describe, you have only three columns. However, on target, we have got eight columns and that too only department number column value matches. So what happens is in GoldenGate, GoldenGate by default replicates the data between column names, which are same. GoldenGate, but the column names, which are different, it is not able to replicate until and unless you define column mapping only. So because we haven't defined during initial load, that's why. But your initial load is successfully completed now. Okay. And how to map different the column names between source and target, we'll discuss in different video for that. So now your initial load is completed. Once your initial load is completed, now what you have to do, you just have to go ahead and start your replicate process. So now you can go ahead and start your REP INT 0. So once your replicate process successfully starts and your time since checkpoint becomes less than 10 seconds, after that, your new table addition is completed successfully.